Welcome to all the participants for this webinar today. Of course, this webinar is being presented by UMS in strategic partnership with InfoPercept. My name is Atulya Sharma, and I am the host for today's webinar. Foremost, thanks to all the audience that have joined us today. The audience comprises IT and cybersecurity domain experts. We've got CIOs, CTOs, and CISOs joining us for this webinar today. And I can't thank each one of you enough for being a part of this webinar that we've tried to put together for you. And I hope you find it meaningful and insightful. Let me start by sharing some metrics about Oman's cybersecurity performance. There is an annual report that is published by the International Telecommunications Union, or ITU in short. They rank different countries on their global cybersecurity performance. And it's really heartening to note that Oman is number 16 on that ranking board. And what's even more heartening to note is Oman is number 2 amongst all the Arab countries in the world. So it's amazing that Oman has been able to manage its cybersecurity services so well. And that's mission critical for all companies today, because digital transformation, as you all know, is absolutely key for every company's performance and sustainability. And to that extent, with good cybersecurity rankings, of course, Oman is in a good place to embark on its digital transformation journey and take it forward by leaps and bounds. Why digital transformation is important today is because companies are no longer just looking at digitizing their products or services, but they're looking at digitizing their processes as well. So products, services, and processes, all three of them are getting digitized. And of course, in that scenario, business continuity planning and incidents reporting becomes absolutely critical for all the corporates. Now, if we look at what happened in March, really a black swan event, as I may call it that, the pandemic happened, and at a mass scale, people were forced to sort of work from home. And that had two challenges that we encountered. One, of course, the companies were forced to give safe access to their employees who were working from home. And the protection of the enterprise system, that became the other key sort of objective for these corporates. But believe you me, in spite of whatever companies are doing today, the threat looms large, because the scale at which people are being forced to work at home, that is unprecedented. And that obviously puts a lot of pressure on the IT infrastructure of these companies. Now, what's happening is that the cyber criminals, if I may call them that, and the vulnerabilities that we might have inherently in our systems, they get exposed in such scenarios. And obviously, we are, just hoping and bracing ourselves against any potential threats and attacks. Now, it's very important that, we sort of consolidate and fortify ourselves against any such eventuality of a cyber threat or vulnerability, because I was reading somewhere, and it's very insightful, they talk about, the first pandemic having attacked human lives, and so many precious lives were lost to that. It should not now become that the second wave of pandemic sort of hits our digital devices and digital systems. That, of course, will be something that today's digital world cannot afford at all. So yes, business continuity is the mandate. And with that objective in mind, we said, let's look at an able ally who could help us in combating and circumventing any digital threats. And we started looking for a partner who we could sort of depend on. And that's when we sort of focused and ended our search by finding InfoPercept, which is a company which is dedicated to info security and cybersecurity. They have 4 cybersecurity centers. They have offices in the US, Kuwait, Saudi, Malaysia, Singapore, Sri Lanka, Uganda, Kenya, and of course India, which is their home base. So InfoPercept, what I found very interesting about them is that they don't look at cybersecurity as just a product, but as a continuous sort of a process and as a journey that they handhold their clients on at every step of the way. So that's what InfoPercept is, and I'm sure Jaideep will share a lot more details about that when he takes the floor. Talking about UMS, how we have entered the digital era. We've been old players in the digital sphere. We embarked on this journey by launching our web development unit when the dot-com boom was happening. So 1997, 1998, we got into creating websites. And today I proudly say that we have more than 450 websites that we have created for clients, big and small corporates, banks, perhaps all of them in the country at some stage or the other. And it's not just that we create websites, we maintain them, we host them, and we do all the updations on them. So it's a comprehensive solution that we offer on that front. Apart from that, we were early on the social media bandwagon, and today we have a huge bilingual team that supports the social media needs of some of the largest corporates, not just in Oman, but also in the UAE. And we not only support them with social media handling of their channels, but also with their online media buying needs. I must talk about our most successful venture on the digital arena, which is businesslivemi.com. I think most of you from Oman would definitely have heard about it. It has a huge following for people who are following business news in this country. And of course, our footprint extends much beyond Oman and expands into all the GCC and of course the Middle Eastern markets. I would urge you to log in and have a taste of Business Live ME if you've not already done so. And our latest endeavor into the digital arena is something that we embarked upon in December of last year, January of this year, which is called Omato.com, which is an e-commerce platform. And of course, I think the timing was right for us because Omato is really succeeding in this time of pandemics when people are scared to sort of go into the retail space. So without much further ado, I think let me introduce Mr. Jaideep, who's the domain expert, and let's hear from him. He'll probably be sharing a presentation with us. He is, of course, a tech-driven entrepreneur who founded InfoPercept. He has great experience in cybersecurity and cybersecurity automation. He looks after security of digital transformation, strategic security engagement, and leadership. He is known for utilizing his pervasive security experience and deep insights into envisioning and formulating successful cybersecurity solutions and strategies for leading companies across the world, including the Middle East. Welcome, Jaideep, to the session. Thanks so much for joining in, and we are anxiously waiting to hear from you. Just some protocol and house rules. Jaideep will make the presentation, and it will be followed by a Q&A session with him, where you could ask him the questions please don't ask me any of these difficult questions on cybersecurity. Jaideep is the expert, and please field all your questions to Jaideep. You need to please just type out your questions in the panel below with your name and your company name. Over to you, Jaideep. I hand over the floor, or rather the screen, onto you now. Thank you.
Thank you, Atulya. Thank you so much. So first of all, I would thank you to Oman as a country, because I'll be talking to Oman as a country for the first time. I've been traveling to a lot of Middle East countries, but never to Oman. So I'm missing it. I'll be soon coming there as well. Thanks to people who have joined, and thanks to people who have joined from other parts of the world as well. Before I start off with my actual slides, I have two illustrative slides which I wanted to demonstrate. So in this slide, what you can see here is like, this is you who is walking on this digital world. The user, the business who is walking, and there are a lot of loopholes around, and there are a lot of attackers who are just waiting for you to commit a mistake. And those are the digital attacks which does happen. So my next slide is where you can see that there is somebody who is patching those loopholes, and he's safeguarding you. So introduction to us as InfoPercept, we are ally in this digital warfare. We are your ally, and what we do is the managed security services. And for Oman, we are working with our partner UMS, which Atulya has already introduced. And with that, we'll be providing our local support to the country wherever required. Introducing InfoPercept's journey in terms of like how we have built this company. So all of us who started off this company, we started off our careers into cybersecurity domain since 2002-03. So we are all almost two decades of experience into cybersecurity. And then we ventured InfoPercept as a company since 2014. So first services that we started off was the offensive security. Then we introduced GRC practices. 2016, we started off with 24/7 SOC. All these years, people have recognized us for helping them to get ROI out of the existing investment, so which was more of an optimization approach. So 2017, we released our optimization approach. 2018, we introduced three centers. Like normally, most of the cybersecurity managed security service providers would have one center, but then we started off two more in 2018, which was SOC, TOC, and COC, all helping customers to optimize their existing investment on different areas of cybersecurity. 2019, we have invested a lot into cybersecurity automation. 2020, we are productizing what all we have done, and we are adapting. And so far with this journey, we have 200 plus clients. We have our presence in 15 plus locations and 12 countries with local partners, and few of the countries where we have our local setup as well. So that has been our InfoPercept journey so far. Coming to about InfoPercept, as Atulya already mentioned, we have been only focusing on cybersecurity, and that's the only sword that we have sharpened. And we have perfected our response to this cyber pandemic, which is happening globally. And we have also taken a learning from Abraham Lincoln, which says that if I had six hours to chop a tree, I would spend first 4 hours sharpening those sharp axe. So that way, what we believe is like cybersecurity strategy is the most important part. And we help customers to strategize their cybersecurity implementations and approaches. About optimization as a journey, because what we have learned is like a lot of companies do have a lot of tools and technologies which they have already invested. But then the challenge with them is that they are not getting the ROI out of it. And optimize has become a key, wherein like what we say is like a war cannot be just won with more arsenal, but what you need is the real optimization strategy. So you need to profile your weapons in such a way that you are able to fight this digital warfare. In the sense, like if we relate it to the real world, then there would be different weapons that can be used to counter attack. Could be a stone, a bullet or a bomb. So you need to profile that which weapon needs to be used at what point of time. So that's how InfoPercept as a company has always been profiling our customers, profiling what tools and technologies needs to be used and how the existing tools can be used to get that real ROI. So that has been the optimization journey for InfoPercept, and we have been helping our customers to get the real return on investments from the existing investments. With all our digital warriors who have been working with a lot of clients across different countries, we have been successful in building a lot of retainer projects for our company, wherein we have 100 plus TOC customers, we have 10 plus SOC customers, we have customers for our COC, for our automation as well, and we have done more than 55 SOC related SIEM projects. And in terms of our offensive security experience, we have tested more than 3,000 applications so far. We have been reviewing network security for more than 250 times. We have been doing cloud security reviews as well. We have done a lot of red teaming exercise for large enterprise and banks across. We have also done projects on OT, IoT review more relevant to the energy sector. And we are currently engaged by large banks across the globe, which is more than 15 banks now. And our vision is to be a premier managed security partner. So what we normally discuss with all our clients is like the war scenarios that we see across, where we quantify it into three different ways, I would say. Wherein the number one is where you know your strength, you know your enemy's strength, which is a kind of known situation, which is a simple battle, which is an easy battle to fight because you are knowing your strength, you are knowing your enemy's strength. So that battle is something which you can fight it out easily. The second scenario which we normally see is where you know your strength, but you don't know your enemy's strength, but which is known unknown kind of situation where still you are knowing your strength. So that battle also is something which you can fight it off. But the third scenario which we see currently, which we see in the physical world as COVID-19, the pandemic, and the same scenario is happening in the cyber world also, where you don't know your strength, you don't know your enemy's strength, which is completely unknown, and which is very difficult for the corporates, governments, and the people around. So that's becoming the most challenging, which is the unknown situation. So that's the war scenario in the digital world. And when it comes to internal world, where in the companies, the way we have the war on the external ground, there is a kind of tug of war which is happening, which is very difficult to quantify even, where you have a lot of people on the other sides of the domain, where you have the HR team, sales, marketing, QA, your IT, development, network. So that's the investment that companies do make. But when it comes to security, people are dependent on one or two resources, and they're dependent on a very lean team, which is becoming very difficult for the companies to fight this battle off. So what you really need is like everybody in this digital warfare needs to contribute to have the real cybersecurity posture. And that's where what we normally talk to all our clients is like, you need to have the right balance of this security team, where you need to have different team who can perform different tasks, because cybersecurity is also a domain where you have different skill set and a different disciplinary which needs to be brought on the table to fight this digital world. So what you need is the red team which does the offensive security for you, who can help you to see what are the gaps in the environment. You have the blue team who does the continuous security monitoring for you. You have the purple team which does the technology implementation. Then we have the pink team who does the process implementation. And then we build various digital warriors, which are the digital bots, security bots, which actually balance the security team for a lot of clients. So that's how we have been helping our customers in building the right team structure to fight this digital world. Then we understand the business IT landscape. Like earlier, when the landscape was just focused on data centers and the on-premises infrastructure, wherein you have your apps, DBs, network systems, endpoints, all on your premises and the data centers. But then now it has extended to the next level where the machines are part of your IT systems. Wherein, like, if it's a banking, then you have various POS machines, you have ATMs. In the manufacturing, you would have the OT, IoT setups, you'll have the SCADA systems in place. So those are the machines which are part of the technology ecosystem. Then with the growing cloud and mobile since last one decade, most of the customers do have their workloads all on cloud, certain workloads on cloud. Mobile has been used for various business application, various business communication. So that is also becoming a very integrated part of this business IT landscape. And when it comes to the third party, which is your agents and the suppliers and the partners ecosystem, which is also becoming a quite integrated landscape, wherein, like, whatever risk you have as a business is getting integrated with the third party, and whatever third party has a risk in their environment is getting quite integrated to you. So that's the overall landscape that we see in most of the businesses across the globe. And we have tried relating it to the actual war as well, where you see on-premises is kind of frontline force for you. Machines are the armories, mobile and the cloud is the rapid deployment force, and the third parties are your force multipliers. So that's the overall IT landscape which we are trying to address, and we are fighting this digital world. Coming to the red SOS situation, which is where we see a lot of cyber threats already happening and the company is struggling. So this attacks are becoming more and more dangerous than the actual physical attacks, because in the physical attacks, you still need to follow those sequences, and there are certain protocols that are being followed. But here the challenge is, like, anybody sitting on extreme end of the world can attack somebody on the extreme right. So that's actually becoming very critical, and there is no sequence even that you need to go from this path to reach out to do this attack, and that way it's becoming more and more danger. And the kind of SOS situations we see with all the clients across is, like, you'll have a lot of invisible enemies in terms of the malwares, the ransomwares, and a lot of different, viruses that are getting planted on different parts of your business IT ecosystem, which is your on-premises, machines, cloud, or third party. There are a lot of attacks which the attackers do to bring down your essential services so that you cannot continue with your business. So these are the attacks, kind of DOS, DDoS, which are happening and which bring down your essential service and doesn't allow you to continue your business. The kind of other attacks that we see is, like, they isolate your actual consumers and not allowing them to access your business application and diverting them to something else, which is a kind of isolation attacks which are being done by a lot of different attacks with different techniques and tactics. And we also see systems getting compromised and we are not able to detect. That is, like, the entire landscape is already compromised and the attackers are using it for their own benefit, could be for mining and the other purposes, and you are still not aware. So that those are the kind of compromised attacks which are becoming a real situation for the global. And then we also see certain attacks where they make a complete target, a planned attack, and what they do is they bring down your business down. That is, like, entire business operation, one day you see a disaster happening and which becomes a loss of complete brand. So that's becoming the most challenging for the CISOs, CIOs, and the IT teams across the globe. And that's the challenge which we are trying to solve. What we see is, like, the way the COVID-19 has struck the physical world, and we keep hearing people talking about that this person is currently infected with the COVID-19 or the coronavirus. The same way what we have seen is since last few months, like, a lot of different levels, different complex, and the different intensity of cyber attacks that are happening across. And what Gartner and the Symantec have researched is since 2009 to 19, which was kind of step-by-step growth where we have seen the cybercrime increasing, but it was step-by-step. But what they are predicting for 2020, which is going to be a cyber COVID kind of situation also, where what we see and the other people who have researched see that this attacks are going to be double the 2019. So it is something where the war is very real and it has already reached you. So that's the area of concern for most of the businesses and governments across. Now, this particular situation is becoming a real worry for most of the businesses where you have your business owners, you have your CISOs who are supporting you to fight this digital war, but then they are not able to focus on their business because that's again a lean team. So the real worry is like they're all waiting for a breach to happen. They're all worried like how to protect the intellectual properties, how to fight this unknown attacks. And with this growing cyber threats across, what you need to comply to run your business is to comply to all your regulatory requirements. And that's where this is becoming a real concern and not allowing people to focus on the core business. So what you need actually is you need that strategy about strategy, have the right aligned place with different team structure to fight and you can focus on your business as a priority. So that's where we as an ally bring out different warriors from our side who are supporting 24/7, 365 days, who help you to establish those security processes that are required. We have the right approach for defense in depth as an approach. We also help customers to optimize what you have. And we also help in validating by conducting a real test around the security posture. So coming to the InfoPercept's battle strategy versus the traditional method. So we have built this strategy because we have been part of this digital world since quite a long. And we see that the current strategy that most of the companies are currently following is not supporting the advanced attacks which are happening. And you really need to think out of the box and carry out those security implementation to fight this digital world. So what we have as a strategy is like we are making it more and more offensive, which is our left, right, and center approach, which is internal as well as external. We also do the security data lakes, which is a kind of big data which we build with the ODA, a strategy learned from the physical wars and added with the A to make it more adaptive, which is a security lakes that we build. Then we also believe that security is not just the security lakes or the big data problem, but you need something which has to be personalized, which should reduce your false positive, and which your blue team can consider as their own ninja. So these are the various strategies that we have. Then we have the moving target defense, which is a concept from the US defense. We also do continuous security, continuous optimization, security in and as code, which is a center that we run. We also have the compliance as a wish rather than a strategy, because most of the time what we have seen is companies do have compliances for the need and not as a wish. And that's where we want to change that perspective. And then we have our own product, which is called as Game Plan. Which is something that we implement with all the clients where we are providing the managed security services, and which is a non-real time, which is a very different unique concept, making it non-real time, but giving you a complete feed across the landscape of what's happening and helping you to strategize your decisions and security program management. And we also build a lot of different digital security warriors in terms of various security bots. So that's the InfoPercept battle strategy. I'll be covering each of this in my slides again. So when we say more offensive, left, right, and center approach, internal, which is like you can see in the real scenario where you have a wall in place, you have a tank besides, but then this is somewhere you are just protecting your ground. But the attack can definitely happen from the air also. So that's the real real attacks that are going to happen, because you have an illusion that you have few security controls in place, but then you don't know what kind of tricks, techniques that the attacker is going to play to actually attack you. So that's where what we do, which is proactively, we make it more offensive from our side. And whatever customer comes to us, we try to do the real breach and attack simulation on those environments. Wherein, if you can see my left side of my slide, what we do is like we act as an attacker itself. We do the information gathering of the customer environment. We try to find few entry points from where we can enter the environment. And once we enter those environments, we try to establish our command control centers. Once we have the complete command control on those environments, we try to do horizontal lateral movement to see what other applications, databases can be reached from that entry point, that command control. And then we do the data assertion and the deliveries, and finally followed by the data exploitation. So with this approach, what happens is we are actually simulating a complete attack on the customer environment, which is simulated, but which will give you a complete insight of if the real attack happens, up to what level the data exploitation can be impacted. So that gives you a real understanding of your current posture and helps you to really improvise. And most of the time, what we have seen is people just do the vulnerability assessment, which is more of a probing-based approach, which gives you the vulnerabilities, but then it doesn't give you the threats across the landscape. And this particular approach is something which we have been doing with a lot of large banks, and they have seen a very good value coming to them, because they always were under the illusions where they see that they have various security controls, they have few team members doing a lot of compliances, technology, but when it came to the real breach and attack simulation, the security systems do fail, and you really need to work on to make it more and more robust. Coming to the external world approach, which is something where we've seen a lot of clients commit mistakes, like people do implement various controls on their company's IT infrastructure and the IT ecosystem, but then they don't monitor the external world. And what we believe is like for your enemies and you to know what your enemies are planning for you, you really need to be part of that ecosystem and see what is getting planned for you. So you need to have that real understanding. So with this, what we do is like our dark web monitoring team is part of the dark world. And what we keep doing it for all the clients whom we are monitoring is we monitor them on the dark nets, the forums, the paste bins, different domains which are getting registered in their company names, the social media accounts which are getting created in their company names, and also do the IOCs that are getting built across, which needs to be actually blocked in your environment as well. And with all this understanding, what you need to do is you need to actually prioritize, analyze all the data that is coming to you. You need to validate, because there are a lot of tools which are available from which you can just run a scan and see what's happening. But that's something which really requires a validation and which requires an experience. And that's what we do in kind of doing a validation of all the data that we capture from all the dark world. And then we contextualize for various teams to act upon, the executive team, the strategic team, the technical team, the GRC team, because all needs to work on once you have this intelligence coming to you. So that's something that we do for all our clients. Coming to our order of battle, which is our four different centers that we have established for cybersecurity, which is namely, the Security Optimization Center. We don't call it as security operations, but we call it as optimization, because we do a lot beyond than just the operations as part of our SOC. Then we have our second center, which is dedicated to help customers optimizing existing technologies and tools, which is called as Technology Optimization Center. We have our Compliance Optimization Center, where we help customers to improvise the existing compliance implementation and integrate various different compliances that you are following. And we have a dedicated center for automation onboarding center where we help customers to build various digital security warriors for you. So these are the four order of battles from our side. And what we believe is like security optimization has to be across the landscape, which should cover the complete landscape, your application, your mobile, OT, IoT, the machine part of it, cloud, infrastructure. So that's the landscape that you need to continuously monitor for the existing and the new threats that are coming up. And what we believe is like you need to be vigilant 24/7, because if the snake is sleeping, it's not that he's going to sleep forever, right? So that's the same scenario which is there for the enemies. You don't know when they will wake up and they will attack you. So you need to be vigilant 24/7, and that's how we run this center 24/7 for our customers. Coming to building the security data lakes, which is like the current communication where a lot of companies talk about the artificial intelligence, the machine learning, big data, security data lakes. But then when it comes to the real implementation, there are various tools that are used to build this security data lakes. But then the challenge that we have seen is it's not actually integrated with the right strategy. Because we have seen a lot of customers investing in SIEM solutions, which is an expensive solution, which can do a lot for you, but it needs to be strategically placed. So what I've done here is like, I've taken a real life scenario where you can see that a step one, which is an observe. So what we do is like using this SIEM, we onboard various data sources on the platform and start observing what is happening. So that's in an attack scenario. The first step is to observe your enemy and what kind of attack he's going to do. So that's what we do using SIEM as a solution. Then it comes to second phase where you see this step two, which is to orient. So when an attacker is going to attack you, you need to orient yourself in the terms of whether he's going to attack you on your stomach, on your head, on your leg. So that orientation is very important. So the four use cases, the security orchestrator and automated response use cases that we build are all to set the right orientation of those attacks which are happening. In terms of, you need to know where the attack is going to come to you. So we have various playbooks, various automations that are written to set the right orientation for you using SOAR as a platform. Then we have the third technology which gets implemented on all the endpoints and all the servers across the landscape, which is called as endpoint detection and response, which is EDR, where we take this step three, which you can see in the real life scenario. But now when you know the orientation of your attacker, you need to decide whether you want to just defend or you want to counter attack. So based on that decision, you need to act, which is the fourth step, which also is done using the same technology, which is the EDR, which is endpoint detection and response. So on the fourth step, you need to decide whether you want to attack, counter attack, or we just want to defend. So that's the complete life cycle, which is actually followed on the physical war also, which is called as OODA, which is observe, orient, decide, and act. And in this entire strategy, since it is the same strategy which is used in IT, and there are a lot of attacks which keep happening again and again, and a lot of learnings also which we get, we have made it more adaptive at InfoPercept. And what we learn is something which we start implementing at other clients also. So we have made it OODAA, which is observe, orient, decide, act, and adapt. So that's the entire life cycle in building the strategy. Then what we as an offensive team, where we all have been part of various red teaming exercise across, and what we have learned is like when the attacks do come, it doesn't allow time to the customers and the technical team. And that's where you need something which is more within offensive mindset, and which is a kind of deception. So deception is something which is used in the real war also. So in the real life scenario, what you can see here is the attacker is trying to attack, and you have the thin wires there. You have different mines also being planted. So what happens is when the attacker is trying to cross and he is not able to see this fire, immediately it gets blasted. And it's very well said that all war is a deception. So deception is the tactic that most of the war has used, and it has helped to fight in a better way. So what we do in the real digital world as well, we use the same concept of deception, of planting various fake network devices, fake systems, applications, databases, fake files across the landscape, fake username passwords on various servers. Because we know the offensive guys or the red teamers or the real attackers who have the foothold, what kind of activities they are going to do to actually do all kinds of lateral movements. So based on that strategy, we'll be planting these real mines across the landscape. And as soon as the attacker who has been successful in bypassing other technologies and is trying to do some kind of horizontal attack, this strategy is something which will immediately detect, and this will actually reduce your false positive because this is the technology which an attacker should never touch, and it gives you a personalized threat intelligence also. So this is one of the key technology which we actually implement with all our managed security customers, and which has actually helped our SOC team to detect the early lateral movement. So that's about the deception. Then in the real war, where you have one watchtower and there is an attacker who is targeting that watchtower. So if you just have one watchtower and the attacker has made up his mind and he's targeting it, then he can really attack that watchtower. So it's very simple scenario for an attacker, because that watchtower is quite static. It's one watchtower. An attacker just need to practice his orientation and he will be able to grab that attack. Second scenario is where you have multiple watchtowers and the attacker needs to target those. But if both of them are static, then again, attacker can have multiple attacks and he can target both the watchtowers. So that's the scenario two. And then we have a scenario where you see multiple watchtower, out of which few watchtowers are fake watchtowers and the real one as well. And what is happening is it's continuously moving. So that particular orientation is very difficult and attacker will never be able to target because that's a moving target. So currently in this pandemic, or all the real attacks which are happening are all memory evasive attacks. Most of them are targeting the memory, because the attackers do have access to the endpoints which are currently work from home, and what they know is the DLL structure of the application. And for all the companies, since there are so many applications which are getting released every day, it's very difficult to have all the applications without any particular loopholes, and it's becoming very difficult to have the complete patching as well. And that's where the attackers are taking the advantage of knowing the structure, and the memory itself is becoming a kind of battle where they are able to target. So we use the same concept which you saw in the real scenario, where we change the DLL structure of all this application, and it is constantly moving, in the sense like the attacker will not be knowing the DLL structure. He will see the different structure and it's constantly moving. So whatever is knowing about the structure will never be right, and he will never be able to focus on the vulnerability. And that's how this particular tactic helps us to protect all kinds of unknown attacks which are currently happening. Then with all the experience that we have with most of the customers, where they already have lot of security assessments done, and they know that there are a lot of gaps on their operating system, but it takes minimum of 50 days for patching those vulnerabilities. For network related patches, it takes minimum of 75 days. For cloud gaps, it takes more than 100 days. for OT, IoT, sometimes more than 200, more than that as well. DR drills doesn't happen for more than 365 days, and application related gaps are becoming endless to patch. So that's where we saw a gap with most of the organization. And this is just a sample concern that we are sharing, which is there for most of the verticals, most of the industries across. And that's where we as InfoPerceptive, what we do is like, we believe in the continuous security, continuous optimization, security in and as code. That is like, we don't want to do the patching once and then wait for the other patches to come, but then we do it on a continuous basis. And security, we are making it as a practice, a culture, where we make it in and as code across the landscape. So the capability that we have built is to support our customers to implement security across the landscape and on a continuous basis. And the various areas that we support are the application, the infrastructure, business continuity, mobile, cloud, IAM, asset security, information rights management. So that are the kind of optimization areas that we help customers across the landscape. We are vendor agnostic. We believe in value proposition, but then there are certain products which are being implemented by our team. There are a good number of tools which are not very expensive. Certain tools are also free, and we use these tools to build a lot of security optimization center for our customers. So we also help customers to optimize the existing tools as well. So these are a few of the tools which we work and which our company is in partner with. Then coming to our compliance optimization center, the challenge that we have seen for our client across is like compliance is becoming more and more complex. And what we see is like the designing the real system is becoming very heavy. And the challenge that the companies across could be oil and gas, banking, the other industries like retail, pharmaceutical, chemicals. So they all have their own critical infrastructure rules and regulations to be followed. They have their own wish-driven few cybersecurity compliances that they are trying to follow. And the cost of compliance is really increasing. And the challenge is like, what you are documenting is not getting implemented. So that's again a concern with most of the companies. And the risk assessment that does happen is kind of working in silos. Like you have one particular standard which the company is following, then the risk assessment for that standard is different than the other standard where you are doing the risk assessment. So that's becoming a challenge. And really implementing the compliance and making it more wish-driven is a challenge. And that's where we have a dedicated compliance optimization center. And what we do is like we shadow the existing team. We don't replace anything, but we shadow the existing team with the gaps that are there. We part with their process team, the risk team, the compliance team, also participate in the technology team and try to shadow and bring out the real value to have the compliance as a wish rather than a need. So that's the approach that we follow as compliance optimization center. And we also implement a platform which is called as GamePlan, which is our own build product, which is like what we have realized is there are a lot of CISOs who have a lot of tools and technologies and they have their teams also in place. But then for them, the challenge is that this overall feedback of the entire ecosystem is becoming very critical because you need to continuously know where is a gap across the landscape. And if you have everything coming to you on a real-time basis, it is very difficult because you'll not be able to think about the strategy. So what we have done is like GamePlan is a cybersecurity product which is non-real-time, which is something very different than all the other products. Because in cybersecurity world, everybody talks about real-time, But then what we as InfoPercept has always believed is it's more about the right strategy. And for having that right strategy, right game plan, you need to have the peace of mind to think about what you need to do in terms of implementing the right cybersecurity controls. So this is the real platform which gives the CISO, a shadow CISO, to see what needs to be done where, and what should be the real program management in terms of the various cybersecurity initiatives that they are following across the landscape. So this particular platform has various use cases in terms of the governance, risk, compliances, strategy, user awareness, culture. So that's what we do by shadowing a CISO using this platform game plan. Then what we have seen is like taking an example of Pentagon or any bank, like we have been discussing with the security guard at a lot of banks that how many attacks, physical attacks that you have seen happening on this particular bank physical infrastructure. So at that time, the security guard would say that in last 6 months, it's just one or two attacks where somebody was trying to enter as a visitor and we had to identify him and we need to isolate him. So when it comes to real large banks also and the physical attacks, what we've seen is like physical attacks have actually reduced. But then when we go to the CISO or the IT security team and ask that how many attacks you have seen in last 6 months, he would say that it's not last 6 months, but in last one day itself, we have seen sometimes more than 1 lakh attacks that are happening, the digital attacks. So, and kind of Pentagon as an example, it's 1 million attacks every day, the digital attacks that are happening to them. So what has happened is like most of the attackers are building the lot of automated bots, which are self-learning. These machines are able to find the vulnerabilities in the customer environment and they are actually penetrating the customer environment. And it's becoming very unfavorable if you have to fight against the machine, because humans cannot fight these machines out. So what happens is like these attacks are being carried out with the mixed strategy of the automation as well as the manual, and where you also need to have the same capability as the defending organization. You also need to have the automation plus the manual ways to fight this digital world. And that's where what we do as part of the automation onboarding center is we understand the threat landscape, we understand various attacks that are happening on the organization, and we try to build the custom security bots which are able to fight this cyber attacks which are happening, and which is kind of the counter attacks to the cyber attacks which are happening. And what we believe is the current age wars are the machine driven wars, and that's where you need to have their own digital army which is called as digital security warriors. And what we do is like we build custom security bots in terms of the voice bots, the chat bots, the real execution bots, the bots which are able to do the incident analysis, counter attack bots, and also the bots which does the continuous threat hunting. So these are the various digital security warriors that we build as part of our automation onboarding center. And the actual advantage is like all these bots are custom specific. It's like the environment specific, because all environments are different, all landscapes are different, and the kind of attacks which are happening also are different. So that's where you need to have something which is more personalized and profiled for your requirement. And that's what we do as part of our offerings. And this four centers that we actually implement or which we offer for our customer as part of our managed security services, namely the SOC, we do have various offerings under this as kind of the continuous monitoring, threat intelligence, threat management, incident response, implementing tools like SIEM, SOAR, EDR, deception, MTD. As part of our TOC, we help customers to do the regular health checkups, product evaluation, security application development. We do technology fine-tuning, integration, onboarding. As part of our compliance offering, we help to do the random spot check, management reviews, internal audits, We help customers to implement the game plan as a platform, conduct the risk assessments. We do the process re-engineering as part of our offerings and trying to benchmark by achieving this process excellence in terms of the cybersecurity processes that needs to be followed. And at part of our AOC, we also understand the overall kind of attack vectors that are happening. And we do the staging of these bots that are required. And we help to roll out this security bots, which are your digital warriors, to fight for you and counterattack the digital attacks that are happening. So that's the catalog of our four different centers that we offer. And the key differentiator for us is like, we have always been believing in 3C, which is the competency, creativity and cost. And the mission is always the people, process and professionalism. And the core values that we have always believed, the people strength, the warriors that we have is the efficiency, effectiveness and enthusiasm, and supported by four different centers. And the customers are always benefited by the new age battle strategy that we roll out based on the needs. The ROI of out of the existing investment, which is our optimization strategy. And what we want to really give to our customers is the peace of mind. And they focus on the business as a priority, and we take care of their cybersecurity. So that has been the philosophy and the methodology that InfoPercept has been successful and has been differentiating from the others. The kind of battalion metrics that we have built is like, we have our offensive and the defensive team. Our offensive teams are also certified with various certifications like CEH, LPT, OSCP, OSCSE. So those are the kind of industry certifications which our offensive team has been successful in completing. We have our defensive teams, which does the implementation of various tools and technologies. The network security, application security, mobile security, OT, IoT. So various tools and technologies that are required to be implemented. And apart from that, we also have our governance, risk and compliance team. And they are also certified with various certifications like CISA, CISM, CISSP, the other certifications like PMP, ISO 27020. So those are the kind of certified battalion metrics that we hold at InfoPercept. And the key takeaway is you need a right game plan, which needs to be structured and divided in phases, because cybersecurity is becoming more and more complex. And we see different intensity of attacks which are happening. And you need to have the implementation or the program management to be done phase-wise, because everything to be done in single phase also is difficult. So what we had seen in the early slide, where we had seen the red SOS situation, where different kinds of attacks do penetrate in the customer environment. So we have this is as a green SOS, which is called as secure, optimize and strengthen. So what we do is like post profiling the customer environment, we divide the entire implementation journey in three phases, which is secure, optimize and strengthen. So secure is the basic controls that you need to implement, where you can see that tank and the firewall is getting implemented. But then this is supposed to, this will not help you when the attack intensity is high. So in the second phase, where you see the optimize, you have somebody who's attacking and is successful in breaking that firewall as well. But at that time, what you need is the optimization strategy, which is the phase where the attack is already launched. So you need to be ready with all different arms and ammunition that are required to fight that attack which is launched. And the final, where he is still going haywire and is successful and is trying to still do a damage, at that time you need to have the strengthen being established, which is a kind of various detections which will be done and the bots that will be built, so you can counter attack the attacks which are happening. So that's the overall journey, the secure, optimize and strengthen.
Jaydi, before I take audience questions, which I have quite a few of them, possibly if you can take us through some use cases, you know, some actual examples of where you were able to be the ally that you're claiming to be and actually help some corporates or customers to be able to combat digital warfare or, actually circumvent any vulnerabilities or any threats that they might have witnessed or experienced. Please, Jaideep, if you can give us some use case example. Thank you.
Sure. So what I'll do is I'll share some of our Middle East customers where we have been successful in helping those customers. So one of the very large bank of Kuwait, where they had their own set of problems, own set of technologies which were already implemented. They already had different teams, but the CIO, the CISO were always worried that everything that is already implemented, but they were still finding it that the attacks are still happening and compromise also are still happening. So what needs to be done? And then we came across them and they also reached out to us as InfoPercept. And then we gave them an approach that we have done the profiling for you. And what we understand is that you have various tools and technologies already in place. So what you first need to do, you need to check whether these tools and technologies which you have already invested are working properly or not. At that time, what we did is like from InfoPercept, we sent few people in terms of our red team and the blue team going on site to the customer site. And we conducted various activities to see the real security posture. And what we came to understand is like there were a lot of tools which were already implemented, but then they were not implemented as per the best practices. And that's how we then give them the complete optimization plan of what needs to be done before investing in new tools and technology. Because the differentiator that we had for the customer was like all the other companies who were talking to them, they were proposing them the new solutions for the existing problems. And we gave them an approach where it was more of an optimization of the existing tools and technology. And then we solved their first problem of implementing all these tools and technologies in a right way, integrating in a right way. We have now started off with the 24/7 SOC for them there in that country also. And we have our local team present there as well. And then followed by, we are also running a continuous security for them. That is our TOC for the client as well. And also supporting them in terms of the compliance requirements as well. So we started off with one specific problem and then they started engaging us with the different sets of services from our side. And they are our customer for various centers that we run for them. Then we have one of the very large manufacturing organization of Kuwait. Almost the problem was same, but then the challenge was, one was the optimization, and they were also trying to procure new technologies for strengthening their current defense landscape. And that's where, when we entered with an approach and helped them to understand what is correct and what is not correct for them. Because profiling, as I said, that optimization is the most important, wherein like you have different weapons for you. Could be a stone as a weapon, a bullet as a weapon, a bomb as a weapon. But then probably which weapon needs to be used where is something which is very critical, because it cannot be an overkill also. So that's how we did the complete profiling. We helped them to optimize. We helped them to trace their security posture. We went on site. We did a lot of activities for them. Then few of our team returned back. Few of our team is currently on site also still. And we are supporting them again 24/7 to run this operations, the security operations for them. Then we have a very large finance company in Saudi Arabia, which was like trying to comply to a lot of requirements from the regulatory, a serious push from the regulatory to comply to more than 200 different requirements. And before 2.5 years, they were kind of like, they had only 8 to 10 compliance out of 250. Though they were one of the very large organizations in Saudi Arabia. And then probably when we got engaged and we saw that there are controls, there are processes in place, but then the missing bit is the real culture and the real skill set is something which is actually missing. And that's where what we did is like we deported various different team members, our the governance team, our risk team, our technology team, our security implementation team, and then we help customers to comply to various the regulatory body requirement. We also help them to build the 24/7 SOC, followed by the 24/7 TOC as well. And we are running their virtual CISO and the other programs for the compliance to their regulatory body as well. And the way we got engaged 2.5 years back, and currently we have almost 6-7 people dedicated to client, and which are continuously helping that customer to protect their security posture. We have an oil and gas company of UAE, which had invested a lot on the security tools. And then the challenge was where they were not able to onboard various devices which are actually required. And then probably we entered that project and helped customer to onboard all the devices. And we are currently supporting them as well on 24/7. So that's our journey, Atulya, with the UAE customers as well. And we are trying to enter Oman, and we seek a good support from Oman customers who have the same case studies for the Oman customers as well. Thank you, Atulya.
I sincerely hope so, Jaideep. We are, of course, on ground to support the local customer base here in Oman. And yes, you know, with the sort of partnership we've been able to forge and the sort of on-ground engineers that we have who can possibly do the hand-holding here in Oman, I'm sure a lot of clients would find our offerings, you know, really needed for this market. And we are ready to sort of help out. Now, let me move to some audience questions. I think we have already overshot on the time. So I'll ask some questions which possibly have not been touched by you. I'll read out the questions. Wherever I feel you've already answered the question, I'll sort of ignore it. And I'll ask you only the ones where I think the audience would require a specific response. So the first lot of questions is from Mr. Mohammed Al-Kharusi. His first question is, quite often it is reported the systems are being hacked and important data is being stolen. What should companies do to ensure that the systems are secured? I think you've answered that very comprehensively. His other question is, due to work from home necessity, employees are accessing company applications and network via public networks. What precautions would you advise companies to implement on their networks to mitigate potential malicious intrusion from both uninvited users or disgruntled employees? You can possibly just touch upon it in brief, Jaideep.
So as I already mentioned, the war is like the battlefield is the memory attacks, and the advantage the attackers do have is like earlier the endpoints were the last point of attack, but currently with this work from home scenario where everybody is working from home, the endpoints have become the first mile of attack. Same way you are using the mobile for various business applications, and most of the customers are using different sets of VPNs to access their business applications as well. And VPN itself is becoming the largest attack surface where there is an illusion that people do have is like we have the antivirus in place on our endpoint. We have the mobile security in place on our mobile devices, and we have VPN, so we are protected. But then the challenge is the attackers do the advanced attack, which is completely unknown. Your defense strategy won't work. So you'll have to have the multiple strategies, the defense in depth that you need to implement on your endpoints, on your virtual private networks. You need to really evaluate your virtual private networks and see what kind of lateral movements can be done using this attack as a surface. And based on that, you need to implement various strategies, and you need to integrate these technologies also to get the right insight for your security operations, because the attack landscape has changed and you need to proactively work on the countermeasures for this particular surface.
Thank you.
And we have a specific approach to this COVID-19 situation, which we have helped customers across the globe. So any of them who has a need specifically for work from home scenario, we can have a one-on-one session as well for them.
Another question, which is in the same realm, is about cybersecurity-led firewalls and constraints usually interfere with the user experience. How can this be avoided? How can we avoid the interference of the user experience with the firewall that we create? Is that a challenge?
So what we believe is, like, not just firewall, but any access control, definitely it may impact a user experience, but then it's a process, it's a journey where you need to have the right implementation done to optimize it so it doesn't impact your user experience, and it also fulfills the security requirement. As a security company, we always say security is a left rather than as a right. So security has to be first. First, you need to implement all the access control, be it like it is impacting a little on your user experience, but then you need to fine-tune those controls, implement it right, so that your security is never compromised. Because giving a user experience or getting your business getting live, but then you are not implementing the right security control, is something which is definitely going to damage your business. And that's where we strongly recommend to implement security as a left, security first rather than putting it last. Be it like you might need to spend more time to get that application or the user experience live, but you need to make sure of implementing those security controls is what we recommend.
Perfect. There are a couple of questions about penetration testing and checking on vulnerabilities. So Mr. Mohammed Al-Kharousi and later Mr. Ilyas Ahmed, they both asked questions related to which company or which vendor do you suggest, you know, the company sort of implement security solutions of? Is there a specific, you know, company whose solutions you're endorsing, or are you, you know, vendor agnostic to that extent?
For our philosophy and our journey has always been on the optimization, where we do the right profiling. And in our penetration testing also, the practice is very different than what other companies would do. In terms of, like, I already explained the left, right and center approach is like, what we do is like, we do the real breach and attack simulation for the customers. So it's not just probing the vulnerabilities that are there on the applications or on the infrastructure, but we try to actually simulate an attack and see what can happen in that particular environment. And based on that profiling, we come out with what should be solution that needs to be implemented. Because when we say defense in depth, normally for a large medium-sized customer, they would definitely need more than 50 or sometimes up to 100 different tools and technologies in cybersecurity space. And that's where you need to profile it first and then have the right strategy of implementation. So it's more of a journey where you need to have the right profiling.
Thank you. Thanks, JD, for that answer. And I think we have a lot many more questions. So what we will do is we will address these questions one-on-one with the participants who are asking these questions. We would also welcome you to sort of, you know, come on a one-on-one engagement with us, whereby we can actually explain to you what exactly we can deploy for your system and what bespoke solution we can offer to you. So yes, we will be taking up some of the issues one-on-one. My last question, Jaydeep, which has come from the audience, is about valuations and assurances, Jaydeep. You know, ISOization of IT systems and IT cybersecurity. Do you offer those sort of services? Is that a part of your portfolio, or are you able to handhold clients on their, you know, ISOization or validation of their you know, assurance systems?
Sure, Atulia. So our center, which is Compliance Optimization Center, we have a dedicated GRC team, and we help customers implement various ISO standards like ISO 27001 for Information Security Management System, ISO 20 for the Service Management Systems, ISO 22301 for the Business Continuity Management System, for the banking kind of client, the banking specific standards like PCI DSS, the healthcare industry, the HIPAA, the regulatory requirements of the OMAR. But the overall purpose of having this center is, like, we don't want customers to find this compliance requirement as a more of a need and a headache, but we want to solve by making it more of a wish and making it more strategic, so that they don't even come to know that they are already compliant to a lot of different standards in terms of the ISOs or the PCIs or the EPAs, but then they get compliant and use it more as a strategy rather than just getting it as a need-driven compliance. So we, yes, answer to your question, our GRC team is experienced with most of the cybersecurity frameworks, even including the NIST framework of the US, which is being followed. And we are also building our own framework, which is an SOS, which is secure, optimized, and strengthened, which also helps to govern the security requirements and also helps you to comply to various ISO and the different industry-specific requirements as well. So that's how we have been helping our customer. And a lot of customers whom they've already engaged us as a retainer, and we are helping them to comply to various different cybersecurity requirements.
Thank you so much, Jaideep. That's very reassuring. So assurance and valuation and validation is something that InfoPersep does. And like I said, more than just, you know, this presentation and whatever we've had to share with you on this webinar, the actual proof of the pudding would lie in you engaging with us and us taking you through what exactly we can do for your organization specifically. So please feel free to sort of get in touch with us. I think I'll wrap up this webinar. Thanks a lot, Jaideep. Thank you very much, all the participants and all the people who took the time to sort of attend this webinar today. Stay safe and stay secure, if I may say that. Thank you.